Nothing but a tall tale. This is what Malacañang thinks of claims by the Sulua Sultanate that foreign assassins are now after the Sultan and his supporters. Stanley Palisada also tells us Malaysia's latest move on Filipinos involved in the Sabah conflict.
Malacañang is not buying the Sultanate of Sulu's claim that a foreign hit squad is in the country with a mission to kill Sultan Jamalul Kiram III and some of his supporters, including his advisor, Pastor Boy Saikon.
This is getting really ridiculous. Every day they're coming out with tall tales. You know, people should stop listening to tall tales.
Presidential spokesman Edwin Lacerda calls it a tall tale, unless the Kirams can substantiate the alleged assassination plot.
We had a previous experience where Jaisal Kiram showed this picture where it showed allegedly Malaysian casualties. This turned out not to be true. This turned out to be a false picture that Jaisal Kiram presented to media. Turns out that those casualties were not Malaysian casualties, but these were casualties of a Thai casualties, and this was taken in 2007. They are now coming out with this another story about people allegedly trying to kill Mr. Jamalul Kiram. That's something that they would have to substantiate.
Lacerda adds that a check by the intelligence community on the supposed plot has yielded negative results. A top military official also plays down the Kiram's claims. Armed Forces Vice Chief of Staff Lieutenant General Alan Luga says the alleged assassination plot could be a mere rumor. The Kiram family is claiming Sabah as their ancestral homeland. Their followers, led by Raja Muda Agbimuddin Kiram, are locked in a standoff in Lahad Datu with Malaysian security forces. So far, the clashes have claimed over 60 lives. Several of Kiram's men have also been arrested. 8 of them were charged Wednesday by Malaysian authorities with terrorism and waging war against the king, an offense that carries the death penalty. Stanley Palisada, ABS-CBN News.